What's going on, guys? So in this video, I wanted to share 4 tips with you that really are gonna help you to make a decision of, you know, which niche you wanna pick for your social media marketing agency. Now, what I wanna start off with is that, you know, at any point, any niche is actually like, has a potential to work really well for social media marketing agencies. However, I do think that, you know, the moment that you're starting with SMMA, there are definitely some niches that are more easy to, you know, lock your door lock your foot in the door compared to other niches. And I wanted to share you some few tips so that you really, you know, are going to be able to pick the right niche this year for your own social media marketing agency. Now, tip number one is definitely I would avoid e-commerce as a beginner. Now, and also, you know, avoid, please, the thought of that, you know, you are going to commit to a particular niche and commit to it as marriage for the rest of your life, right? And this is just something that I can tell from my own experience. I mean, I help skincare e-commerce clients. However, when I started, you know, I started actually with offline skincare clinics and also with dermatologist clinics. And that really helped me to kind of like build a really good experience with, you know, skincare and all of that, and to actually like evolve slowly but surely with organic marketing into the e-commerce space. So when you are planning to do e-commerce in the long run, make sure that you pick a sub niche, and then from that sub niche, you know, pick an offline business that's very close within that industry that you can start off with, and then you can slowly evolve into the e-commerce space later onwards. However, as I said, I would avoid e-commerce to start off with, and there are 2 reasons for that. Number one, it's because e-commerce clients, you know, they tend to have more knowledge about Facebook ads and all of that. So they also tend to be a bit more picky, and, you know, especially when you're starting out and you're not really sure about Facebook ads yourself or like the return on investment that you can provide, these clients can be more difficult to lock in, as well as that they are harder to find. You know, it's harder to actually gather a lot of emails that you can like get in a huge amount. So when it comes to e-commerce, like what works really well is like a referral system or organic marketing. And that works really well if once you've already built up some experience with, you know, and testimonials of clients that you've already been working with. So that's why I tell you, you know, avoid e-commerce to start off with, but instead pick a sub niche for, you know, e-commerce if you want to do that long term, and then find an offline business first. Now, the second tip that I want to give you is that I know that a lot of people say, you know, focus on high ticket niches. And I definitely agree with that, that that's a lot easier. However, I want you to think in addition to that, that you're not only focusing on, you know, high ticket niches, but instead also focus on the opportunity that's out there. And what I mean with that is, like, in my opinion, like the best business opportunities for digital marketers this year is really niches that have a very hard time with keeping up with the you know, technological economy, with the digital economy. For instance, accountants is a great example of this. These are niches that, you know, I mean, I can pull up some statistics, you know, if you Google it, like you can see it from statistics actually that, you know, businesses that are not keeping up with the digital market, these are niches that are going to be completely wiped out in the next few years. Now, as a digital marketing, as a marketer, as a social marketer, that's a great opportunity for you, right? So if you are, you know, be creative with this, find niches that have current trends, that are, you know, they have a very hard time to keep up with the current digital economy. Because once you, as a digital marketer, can really, you know, provide a service that is going to help them make that shift, and you start to really build, you know, your establish yourself as an authority in that industry, trust me, you know, it doesn't matter if they don't get paid a lot, you provide a lot of value. And the moment you provide a lot of value, that's when you can charge high prices. So I would definitely say, you know, instead of like focusing only on high ticket niches, focus on the opportunity that is out there to make a shift for a business, you know, to actually become digitized. And the last tip, or actually like a few more tips that I want to give, but like what I would definitely say, another tip is that you speak to a niche, and of course you want to be interested about the niche, right? But what I think is much more important is actually if you have niches that you already have an existing network in. And now, by all means, you know, when you have that, go out and, you know, contact first, you know, first connections that you have within the industry. But also, you know, keep in mind that even if they are not interested at this point, the moment you lock in your first client and you are, you know, within that particular industry, that's when a network effect is really going to take off, right? So, and you're going to feel like you're on top of a wave surfing, right? So this is, and that's really, really powerful. And I see that with a lot of success students, they have actually picked niches that they already had a lot of working experience in, or that they've already worked within for a couple of years. So definitely that's very, very powerful if you have existing experience within a particular, you know, market or niche. And then the fourth one is that at all times, keep in mind that there is no perfect niche out there. And I want to really emphasize that, because everyone at any point will come into the moment that you start wondering whether you picked the right niche. I've had many of those moments. And it is important that for yourself, you know, as I said earlier, you know, don't think that this is a commitment you make for the rest of your life. But do keep in mind that you do want to make a, you know, a decision right now, because a man who chases two rabbits catches none. So you want to make sure, you know, really become a special, like an expert in a certain field within the next few months, and really make sure that you get to know the language, you speak the language of the niche, you talk to a lot of business owners within that niche, and that will really help you, you know. But at any point, you know, if, don't expect that there's any niche out there these days that if you send, you know, 100 emails that you get 100 emails back that all say, yes, I want to work with you. It's non-existent. You will get, you know, probably like 95% will say no, and then the 5% are actually the clients. And that's why you always want to continue with the outreach and be consistent with that to get back to that. But keep in mind, there's no perfect niche, guys, and anyone has that moment, but it's important that you stick to the niche. Now, this was all I had to share for you today. If you have any questions, let me know down below, and then I'll see you guys in the next video.